Miaka kumiaka mirembe kumirembe.
And then the fire of God.
Urono muriro gwa Katonda.
The Bible says Moses raised up his hand.
Bible gama Musa na yimuse mikono
gye. And the fire of God.
Omuriro gwa Katonda.
Came down on Egypt.
Neguka wansi ku Misiri.
Call down the fire tonight.
Na wali ko wala muriro gwa Katonda.
Oneni bondage in your life.
Elibuli busebeli obulamu bwo.
You are a child of God.
Kwe mwana wa Katonda.
You belong to the house of Israel.
Oli wa nyumba ya Israeli.
There should not be any bondage. Anything that still holds you represents Egypt. We call down the fire of God. We raise up our hands like Moses to every bondage, every habit, every sickness, every pain, every heart that still holds us, even in Israel. That still holds us, even after we know our God. That still holds us, even after we can pray. The children of Israel could pray to their God, but they were still slaves. Anything that still holds us, that keeps us under it, that makes us work as slaves, that keeps us in bondage, when we know our God, we call the fire of the Holy Spirit to sit on it tonight. The fire of the Holy Spirit to rain on it tonight. In the name of Jesus, every bondage must go. Every stronghold must go. We call the fire of God on the bondage of lack. We call the fire of God on the bondage of poverty. Anything that holds you captive in a land that is not yours. Poverty is not your portion. Your portion is that of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. You were born again. Moses raised his hands and the fire came down upon Egypt represents bondage. Not bondage for the heathen, but bondage for the believers. There is a bondage in everyone else's life. The fire of God upon every bondage. The bondage of depression. Every bondage that holds the children of Israel. We speak the fire of God to rain down tonight on our bondage. Moses raised his hand and the fire of God came down. Every bondage of pain, every bondage of lack of satisfaction, every bondage of poverty, the children of Israel were enslaved. They worked so hard and they were never paid. Every bondage that causes us to work so hard and never be paid. Every bondage that causes us to travail, to wake up early and never grow rich. Every bondage that causes us to tire out and never achieve. Raise your hands tonight. The fire of God is available. The children of Israel worked hard and they never achieved everything. But when the fire of God came down, they achieved in one day what they had not achieved in 400 years. They achieved in one day what they had never achieved for generations. When the fire of God came down, God said to the children of Israel, go and get those things of silver. Go and get those things of gold. and walk out of Egypt with them. May the fire of God rain tonight for restoration. May the fire of God rain tonight for compensation. May the fire of God rain tonight. Moses raised up his hands and the fire of God rained upon Egypt. What does Egypt represent? Egypt represents chains. Every slave is chained. They want to go, but they can never go. They want to do what they want to do, but they can't do it. Tonight, the fire of God on every chain that holds you, the chains that hold your womb. There are people that are watching tonight and you cannot have children. The chains that hold your ability to get a job. There are people that are watching tonight and you cannot access a job. The chains, in the name of Jesus, the fire of God to rain upon these chains, the power of God, the Holy Spirit is available to come onto each and every chain and break it in the name of Jesus. What does Egypt represent? Egypt represents chariots. Egypt represents those who pursue you after you have your freedom. When the children of Israel were ready to rush out, when they were ready to go out, when they were ready to escape, the Egyptians came after them. Fire from heaven to rain upon every ancestral spirit that follows you from your family, from your ancestral line, from your background. The spirit of premature death, we speak the fire of God over it. Everything that follows you. Egypt decided to follow Israel. You cannot be followed. You cannot be followed. Everything that follows you must fall into the Red Sea tonight. The blood of Jesus swallows it. Fire. The fire of God. The power of the Holy Spirit upon everything that follows you. You don't know, but there are habits that have followed you. You don't know, but there are situations that have followed you. Fire to every situation that has followed you, to the point that you cannot get married, to the point that you cannot sustain a marriage, to the point that you will never build. Egypt followed Israel. There are situations that are following you tonight. Speak the fire of God. Speak the fire of God. Moses raised his hand. Moses raised his hand. Moses raised his hand. And the fire of God was made manifest in Exodus chapter 9, verse 23. Moses raised his hand and fire rained upon Egypt in the name of Jesus. Every spirit that runs after you from your ancestral home, the spirit of rejection, the spirit of hatred, the spirit of lack of favor, you identify it in your ancestors. You can see it in yourself. Egypt was following Israel. Tonight, the fire of God upon every spirit that follows you, every spirit that rides on chariots, that rides on horses. The Bible says that the Lord looked upon the chariots of Israel. The Lord looked upon the chariots of Israel, and he weakened their wills. Tonight, the fire that weakens wills, the fire that weakens wills, your enemy has been chasing very fast. The demonic trail upon you has been very fast. You have prayed and you have fasted, but Egypt has been running after you. Tonight, Moses raised his hand and there was fire from heaven, and there was fire from heaven, and the fire from heaven, the fire from heaven burned down in Egypt. The fire of the fire from heaven burned down from heaven. Tonight, everything that followed you, Egypt followed Israel. The sorcery and the divination, the night dancing and the sleepwalking, everything that those habits, every demonic spirit that followed you to Israel from the land of the Egyptians, speak the fire of God. Raise up your hand like Moses. It will burn tonight. It will burn tonight. The power of God is present. The fire of God is present. He says that he is a consuming fire. May he consume. May he burn. May he destroy. May he come to an end. Every spirit that follows you, there are other spirits that followed you from the world. They did not follow you from your family. They followed you from the world. Fire of God upon every habit, the fornication and the adultery, the drugs and the alcohol, the smoking and the confusion, the lies and the theft, they are not supposed to follow Israelites. They followed you from Egypt. Egypt represents that which pursues. Egypt represents that which does not give up. Egypt represents that which wants to follow you to your promise. Tonight you are raising your voice and you are saying, I am calling down the fire of the Holy Spirit. Like Moses, we are leaving Egypt behind. We are taking only what is ours. Moses said to Pharaoh, we will take our wives, we will take our children, we will take our cattle. You are taking what is yours. Egypt represents that which wants to hold what is yours. Pharaoh wanted to hold on to the wives of the Egyptians. Pharaoh wanted to hold on to the children of the Egyptians. Pharaoh wanted to hold on to what belonged to the Egyptians. That is why he was saying to Moses, you can go, but let your children stay. Egypt represents that which holds what is yours. Tonight, there is a spirit that is holding your marriage, a spirit that is holding your breakthrough, a spirit that is holding your health, a spirit that holds your relationships. Call down the fire from heaven. Moses raised his hand, and the fire came upon Egypt. Egypt represents that which holds what belongs to you. Pharaoh, today you must let us go. Let our wealth go. Let our health go. Let our health go. We are taking our health. We are taking our prosperity. We are taking our marriages. We are taking our children. We are taking our peace. You are not holding on to anything. Raise your hands tonight. Raise your hands tonight. The fire of God upon Egypt. Moses raised his hand, and the fire of God fell upon Moses. The fire of God fell upon Egypt. Egypt represents that which holds what belongs to you. There are people who are watching. Egypt is holding your job. Egypt is holding your future marriage. Egypt is holding your relationship. Egypt is holding your health. Egypt is holding what belongs to you. The fire of God upon every spirit that has taken away what Jesus has rightfully given to you. He has made you to be above and not beneath. He has made you to be the head and not the tail. Oh, come on, somebody.
Amen.
Begin to pray right now. The fire of God upon anything that Egypt is holding. The fire of God upon everything. Egypt, let our health go. Egypt, let our health go. Let our marriages go. Let our ministries go. Let our children go. Let our money go. May the fire from heaven come down and rain on Egypt. Moses raised his hands, and the fire came down and rain on Egypt, and rain on Egypt. The fire of God tonight, the fire of God tonight upon anything that holds you. What does Egypt represent? Egypt represents that which wants to kill your children. Herod was after the firstborns of the Israelites. Herod was after the children of the Israelites. Egypt represents that which wants to kill the tomorrow generation. Every spirit in your home, every spirit in your family that is attacking your children, that wants to destroy them, that wants to cripple them, that wants to bring them to an end. Every spirit that wants to cripple your siblings, that wants to bring them to an end, the fire of God tonight, the Father of God tonight, the fire of God tonight. Egypt cannot kill your children. Moses raised his hand and the fire of God came down upon Egypt. Tonight, may the fire of God be upon every spirit that pursues your children. If your children are in drugs, just lift up your hands and call fire upon this spirit. We rebuke the spirit of Egypt, the spirit of Pharaoh, the spirit of Herod that pursues children, that kills the younger generation. We rebuke it in the name of Jesus. We rebuke it in the name of Jesus. The consuming fire of God, raise your hands tonight. Raise your hands tonight. Tonight is a warfare night. We are calling the fire of God. Moses raised his hand and the fire of God raised upon Egypt. The fire of God rained upon Egypt. Tonight, may the fire of God rain upon every spirit that pursues tomorrow's generation. Our children will grow old. Our children will get married. Our children will have grandchildren. Our children will have great grandchildren. Raise your hand. Egypt represents that which pursues children. Oh, tonight, every spirit of bad health, if your child is not doing well at school, the fire of God, the fire of God upon Egypt. Moses raised up his hands and the fire of God was prevalent on Egypt. Tonight, every confusing spirit upon our children, every spirit that pursues their education, that pursues their spirituality, that pursues their mind, that pursues their health, every spirit of Pharaoh that runs after the boy children. Oh, come on, someone, begin to raise up your voice. Fire upon every attack on the male child in your house. The fire of God, the power of the Holy Spirit to rain upon your children. The Bible says your young men shall see visions. In these final days, they are supposed to serve God. They are not supposed to be attacked. Egypt represents that which attacks young men, that which attacks baby boys, that which attacks men, that which attacks firstborns. Oh, come on, somebody, the fire of God, the fire of God, the fire of God, the power of God, the Holy Spirit tonight upon anything that pursues your male child, that pursues your firstborn. Egypt represents an attack on the firstborn. Lay your hands on your child tonight. If he's far away, if she's far away, raise your hands. Fire the Holy Spirit spirit, the power of God, the fire of God upon Egypt. Moses raised his hands and the fire of God came down upon Egypt. Moses raised his hands and the fire of God came upon Egypt. Moses raised his hands and the fire of God came upon Egypt. What does Egypt represent? Egypt represents every spirit, every force that does not want you to multiply. Every force that does not desire you to grow. Every force that does not desire you to spread out. The Bible says that Pharaoh wondered why the children of Israel continue to multiply, yet they were being mistreated. And that is why he decided to pursue their firstborn and to deny them working materials. Every force that doesn't want you to multiply, call the power of the Holy Spirit, the spirit of limitation. You work so hard, you get your money, but you lose it in debt. You lose it from theft. You lose it from misguided living. You have looked to multiply and you have failed to multiply. The fire of God upon Egypt tonight. The fire of God upon Egypt tonight. You will multiply. The command of God is go forth. Multiply. Replenish the earth. Subdue it. Stand on the command of God. Stand on the word of God. Stand on the word that he gave Adam and Eve. That is your word. You will see multiplication. Your businesses will multiply. Your family will multiply. Your children will marry and have other children. Every spirit of lack of multi, every force that stops you from multiplying is being burnt by the fire of the Spirit of God. Every force that prevents you from growing is being burnt by the fire of the Spirit of God. Come on, somebody. The fire of God. Moses raised his hand and the fire rained from heaven. Moses raised his hand and the fire rained from heaven. You belong to a lineage of multiplication. Abraham started alone and he became and the lineage became Abraham, Isaac and Jacob. It was a multiplying lineage. You shall not be barren. They will not be miscarriages. That is the word of God. You belong to a lineage that multiplies. Abraham was poor, but when he went to the land that God showed him, God blessed him. God blessed him. And that is a blessing we are still walking in. And by the time he died, he was rich in cattle. Hallelujah. He was rich in cattle. He was rich in health. He was rich in wealth. Tonight, in the name of Jesus, raise your hands like Moses did. Moses raised his hands, and the fire of heaven, came down and consumed Egypt.
Egypt.
What does Egypt represent? Egypt represents the spirit of exile. That which keeps you away from the ones you love. That which keeps you away from your marriage. That which keeps you away from your job. Fire upon Egypt. Every spirit of exile that has thrown you out of your job, that has thrown you out of your family, that has thrown you out of your marriage, that has thrown you away away from the people you love, every exile spirit that causes your loved ones to run away from you so that you cannot access them, and yet you know God, the Israelites were in Egypt and that was not their land. Oh, come on, somebody. Fire upon God. Fire upon Egypt. You have been exiled from your marriage. Fire upon Egypt. You have been exiled from your family. Fire upon Egypt. You have been exiled from your children. You ran away from your husband. And you don't know how your children are doing. Egypt represents the fire of the spirit of exile. Egypt represents the spirit of exile. Tonight, in the name of Jesus, raise up your hands like Moses did and call the fire of God upon Egypt, because Egypt has continued to pursue you even though you are an Israelite. Egypt has continued to pursue you even though you serve God. Egypt has continued to pursue you. The fire of God, the fire of God, the fire of God. What does Egypt represents? Egypt represents discrimination. Egypt got the children of Israel and threw them in their own territory. They put them in Goshen. They isolated them. They stood afar from them. They refused to associate with them. Fire upon Egypt. To every spirit that isolates you, every spirit that discriminates you, they don't want you to give you that job because you are black. They don't want to give you that promotion because you are a woman. They don't want to let you in because you are a certain type of person. They despise you because of what you look like. They don't want to partner with you. They don't want to associate with you. Egypt represents the spirit of isolation. The fire of God tonight upon every spirit of isolation. The fire of God tonight upon every spirit that causes people to discriminate you, to treat you that you are than, like you are less than them. You have been discriminated in your family. You have been discriminated in your workplace. You have been discriminated in your social circles. You may even have been discriminated in your place of worship. But Moses raised his hand and fire and hail and lightning came down. Raise your hands tonight. The fire of God upon every spirit of isolation. The fire of God against every spirit of discrimination. You cannot be isolated. You have been set apart. Not to serve Him, not to be isolated. Tonight, we decree and decree that you are a royal priesthood, that you are raised, you have raised up the banner of Jesus, and He will draw all people and they will come to you. The fire of God upon every spirit that causes you to be isolated, we speak against it tonight in the mighty name of Jesus. We speak against it tonight in the name of Jesus. Egypt represents isolation. Egypt represents isolation. Moses raised his hand and the fire of God came down. What does Egypt represent? Egypt represents scarcity. They gave them nothing to work with. And yet they were supposed to do so much. There was scarcity of joy. There was scarcity of peace. Tonight, raise your hands like Moses did. The fire of the Holy Spirit, the consuming fire of God, must rain down on every scarcity in our lives. He came that we might have life and that we might have it more abundantly. We come against the spirit of scarcity. He has caused us to be above and not beneath, to be the head and not the tail, to lend to many nations and never borrow. Every spirit of scarcity, we rebuke you tonight. Every spirit of scarcity, we speak against you tonight. The fire of God, the fire of God, the fire of God, to rain down upon that Egypt of scarcity. There will be abundance from today. Raise your hands. Raise your hands. Moses raised his hands and the fire of God was made manifest in Egypt. Moses raised his hands and the fire of God was made manifest in Egypt. What does Egypt represent? Egypt represents affliction, mistreatment. Egypt represents discomfort. The children of Israel were afflicted. Tonight, we raise up our voices. The Bible says the children of Israel raised up their voices and cried out to God by reason of their affliction. Egypt represents affliction. Every force that afflicts you, whether during the day, whether during the night, every spirit that afflicts you, tonight in the name of Jesus, we are calling the fire of God. We are calling the fire of God to be made manifest in the Egypt of affliction. Exodus chapter 9 verse
23.
My version says, and Moses raised his hands under hail and the lightning and the fire. I will read it again. Exodus chapter 9 verse 23. Then Moses stretched out his staff toward heaven, and the Lord sent thunder and hail and fire ran down to the earth, and the Lord rained hail upon the land of Egypt. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Raise up your hands like Moses raised the rod. On the fire of affliction. On the spirit of affliction. On the Egypt of affliction. Exodus chapter 9 verse 23. That is where we are praying from. For those of you who have just joined us, there is a fire that must come down upon the spirit of Egypt. You are being afflicted by evil dreams. You are being afflicted by spirit husbands. You are being afflicted by diseases in your body. The fire of God upon the Egypt of affliction. Tonight in the name of Jesus, Moses raised his hand and the fire of God rained down upon Egypt. Every spirit of affliction must leave you tonight. He who the sun sets free is free indeed. Where the spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. Somebody decree and declare it in the name of Jesus. You are free. There is no more affliction in our bodies. There is no more affliction in our organs. There is no more affliction in our blood. There is no more affliction in our health. There is no more affliction in our life. There is no more affliction in our body. Come on, somebody, raise your voice. The spirit of affliction tonight must come to an end in the name of Jesus. The fire of God upon the Egypt of affliction. The fire of God upon the Egypt of affliction. The fire of God upon every Egypt of affliction. Moses raised his hand and fire ran down to the earth, and Egypt witnessed hail. What does Egypt represent? What does Egypt represent? Egypt represents sorcerers and diviners. Egypt represents witchcraft. Do you know that Pharaoh, when Moses performed the miracles from God, Pharaoh brought in his magicians Pharaoh brought in his wizards. Pharaoh brought in his witch doctors. It represents sorcery. It represents divination. But Moses raised up his hands, and the fire of God rained down. The fire of God rained down upon Egypt in the name of Jesus. Every divination, every sorcery, every power of the enemy is burning tonight. The divination that pursues you, the sorcery that pursues you, the Bible says that we will not suffer a witch to live amongst us. The word of God says that there will be no sorcery against Israel, not divination against Jacob. Every curse is becoming a blessing. Raise your hand tonight. May the fire of God rain down upon Egypt, the Egypt of divination, the Egypt of sorcery, the Egypt of divination, the Egypt of magic. Every divination conducted against you meets the consuming fire of God. He says our God is a consuming fire. He is a jealous God. He cannot be made to compete with witchcraft. Tonight, every witchcraft that has been sent against us, we speak the fire of God. We speak the spirit of God. We speak the fire of God. We speak the fire of God. The Holy Spirit to combat. When the enemy comes in like a fly, the Spirit of the Lord will raise up a standard against you. In the name of Jesus, Lord Jesus, precious Holy Spirit, raise up a standard with your fire. Raise up a standard with your fire. Raise up your hands against the Egypt of sorcery. Raise up your hand against the Egypt of divination. Every sorcery from your lineage, every sorcery from your environment, every divination against my children, every sorcery, every negative word, every magic, every witchcraft against my health, against my family, against my marriage. Come on, somebody, the fire of God tonight to consume. The fire of God tonight to burn. The fire of God tonight to wipe out. The power of God tonight to totally destroy. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. The consuming fire of God to wipe out, never to return. Raise your hands like Moses did. Exodus chapter 9, verse 23. And the Lord sent thunder and hail and fire upon the earth, and Egypt witnessed the hail. May the fire of God, may the fire of God tonight rain down. upon affliction, upon lack, upon scarcity, upon the things that pursue your children, upon bondage, upon pain, upon witchcraft, upon everything that Egypt represents, in the name of Jesus, we thank you, power of God. We thank you, Holy Spirit. We thank you, glory of God. Be made manifest in our lives. Even as we go forth, may the consuming fire that is the pillar of the Lord, and it is his name that goes ahead of us, continue to consume, continue to burn, continue to bring to an end, in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Master. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. We praise you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Father, for this time of intercession. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Master. We praise you tonight. Just glorify him and thank him. Lift him up. I praise you, Lord. I glorify you. I thank you because you are the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. You are the one that teaches my hands to war and my fingers to battle. Thank you for showing me that the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but they are mighty through him, to the pulling down of strongholds. Thank you for showing me that I am not wrestling against flesh and blood, but tonight I wrestle against principalities. I wrestle against powers of darkness. I wrestle against rulers of powers of darkness. I wrestle against wickedness that exalts itself on high. Lord Jesus, I come to you today and I thank you because you are a mighty man of war. You are the Lord that leads us in battle, and tonight you have gone ahead of us as the consuming fire, to burn, to displace, to subdue, to bring to an end. We glorify you, Lord. We praise you, Jesus. We worship you. Just spend a few minutes praising him. The Bible says when they sent Judah ahead of them, they saw victory. The Perizzites fell. The Jebusites fell. The Canaanites fell. We sent Judah first. We praise you, King of Kings. We praise you, Lord of Judah. We glorify you, Heavenly Father. You are worthy of all honor. You are worthy of all praise. There is none like you. There is victory tonight. I feel it in the atmosphere. The spirit of Egypt is burning. The spirit of Egypt is being consumed. The spirit of Egypt is being brought to an end in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Master. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. We praise you, Lord. We praise you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I know that I was going to go into the word tonight, but I feel led by the Spirit for us to go straight into worship. This is a time of victory. I would like a Brother Dennis to come on and give us at least 3 powerful songs. We are going into battleground and we are celebrating victory and we are worshiping him. I don't want to interrupt the flow. There must be worship right now. Send Judah ahead of you. When the children of Israel shouted, the walls of Jericho came down. You need to open your mouth as the psalmist comes on. You need to worship, you need to praise. You need to glorify and thank him. You need to honor him. At such a time as this, he is worthy of all the honor. He is worthy of all the praise. As you shout tonight, there are walls coming down. As you shout tonight, Judah is going ahead of you. The Bible shows us in Micah chapter 2 that there was a loud shout from the remnants and the breaker went ahead of them. They cannot be breaking without shouting. They cannot be breaking without praising. They cannot be breaking without worship. Let us dedicate our hearts tonight and begin to praise. Let us dedicate our hearts tonight and begin to worship.
Katonda ayanukuza omuliro banja bakukola noyanukuza omuliro oli Katonda ayanukuza omuliro natukusinza wereza omuliro gamba oli Katonda
oli Katonda Ayanukuzomuliro Banja bakukola Noyanukuzomuliro Oli Katonda Ayanukuzomuliro
Natukusinza
Werezomuliro
Mugamo Oli Katonda
Oli Katonda
Oli Katonda
Ayanukuzomuliro
Tuliwa
Oli Katonda, ayanukuza omuliro.